Good day, this is Jim Pytel from Columbia Gorge Community College. This is Digital Electronics. This lecture is entitled JK Flip-Flop Examples. Okay, so what we're going to do is do two quick JK flip-flop examples and see if we're tracking from what we learned in the last lecture. And before we go into this here, let's do a super brief review about what JK flip-flop does. It's got some inputs, J and K. J, if you can think about it, it's kind of like S. It's kind of like the set command. K is kind of like R. It's kind of like the reset command. When you try to set something, Q should go to 1. If you try to reset something, Q should go to 0. Okay, and if I am neither setting nor resetting my device, my Q should just stay whatever its prior state was. The JK flip-flop, the major advantage of it, unlike the SR latch where if you try to simultaneously set and reset it, this thing goes into what's called toggle mode. What is toggle mode? Basically, whatever Q was, it switches to its opposite state. If it was a 0, it goes to a 1. If it was a 1, it goes to a 0. Additionally, we discussed these asynchronous inputs called preset and clear. And again, they're asynchronous. They do not have to happen with respect to the clock. And if there is input that is synchronous, i.e. respect to the clock, they supersede that. Okay. And because there's a bar over them, preset, if there's a 0 on preset, I will put a 1 in. If there's a 0 on the clear, I will put a 0 on Q. Briefly, to surmise what we've got going on here, is this little mini truth table. If J is 0 and K is 0, what mode is it in as it's lying in wait for, in this particular example, positive clock signal, positive edge? And just think about that. It's just lying in wait, waiting for that clock signal's positive edge to tell it, okay, go into this mode. That mode, 0, 0, I'm neither setting nor resetting, is going to think of as a memory. What about 0, 1? Thinking of resetting. 1, 0, setting it, and finally 1, 1, I'm in a toggle mode. And I can get myself set up in those modes prior to that positive edge clock arrive, and as soon as it does arrive, I go ahead and reset it, set it, or toggle it, or just stay where I'm at. Let's go ahead and do a timing analysis of this. Okay, step 0, where are those asynchronous inputs? What I've got here is I've got preset and clear right there. They're active low. I'm seeing a 0 right here. Regardless of what's on that thing, I know at that moment Q is going to be 0. Go ahead and figure out when this thing is triggered. Well, it's triggered on a positive edge. Go ahead, find your positive edges. So there's all my positive edges. And what is that positive edge looking at? Well, it's looking at the synchronous inputs, J and K. So basically, I'm going to look at those inputs only on those positive edges so I can kind of just draw a line down and where they intersect J and K. That's the mode that I'm in. So go ahead and draw those lines. Okay, so that's where I'm sampling those synchronous inputs. And if you want to, you can really just go ahead and kind of just tell yourself right now what modes I'm in. That first one, I'm neither setting nor resetting. I can call that as I'm in memory mode. I've got a J1, K0. I'm in set mode. J1, K0, set. So you can kind of give yourself that cheat sheet all the way across. You don't necessarily have to do that, but that's a great assistance to figuring these things out. Memory, reset, reset. What happens here? This is kind of a neat thing. J is 1 and K is 1. I'm simultaneously setting and resetting. Well, for a JK flip-flop, that's known as toggle mode. Okay, I'm in memory. What about this positive edge right here? Do I care what that is? No, because check it out. I've got the active low clear. I know I'm in set mode 1, 0 now, but I've got the active low clear. By the way, that previous one was a memory state. I'm in memory state. But again, that, finally, our last one, memory, memory. Go ahead. What does Q look like? Our Q initial condition, it looks like our initial condition is a 0. Go ahead and do your best estimate as to what Q might look like. It should look something like this. And there you go. If it was a 1, that memory state, excuse me, if it was a 0, that memory state, it's going to keep it as 0. It was a 0. Set it. What happens when you set something that's already set? Stays set. It's in memory. It's resetting at that moment. The moment of the positive edge, it resets. Not when it receives a reset command, only at that positive edge. Okay, I'm resetting something that's already reset. Very interesting. Toggle. It was a 0. Now it goes to a 1. It's memorying that 1 state. Finally, we receive that active low clear, and all the rest of them are memory states. So this is a classic example of a timing diagram with a JK flip-flop. How do you practice these things? Go ahead and just do them hundreds of different times of any different combinations of J's and K's and presets and clears. just how would this thing behave if it was a negative edge detection device? Speaking of which, let's do that for a second example. Here's your second example right here. Now, Q is unknown. Go ahead and see if you can figure this thing out. In this particular case, attention to detail, negative edge detection device. Where are the edges? Just go ahead and draw out those edges. What is J and K at those edges? Before you've done all that, what are our asynchronous inputs? Preset and clear. Go ahead and do your best estimate what you think this might be. And remember, Q is in an unknown state. What you should do is get something for Q that looks like this. Okay, so Q should look something like this. Let's go ahead and talk how we got this value. Okay, first off, Q was in an unknown state, or was it? Look at that, got an active low clear. We're basically, before we even start using this thing, we clear it out. It's always a great idea, just get rid of all the junk that's in this, because what is a JK flip-flop? One of its major applications is a memory. Get rid of whatever's in there, it's cleared out. At which point we start taking synchronous inputs, because if you look at clear and preset, there are no other times it's active low. Where is this device taking synchronous inputs? It's taking on the negative edge of the clock and the clock only. So where is that? It should look like this. There you go. It's taking those synchronous inputs on the negative edge. Now go ahead, just use our description of the negative edge detection JK flip-flop. What happens at those negative edges given those inputs J and K? Okay, there you go. So the first time that negative edge occurs there, we've got a set command. We're going to set it again. We're going to go into memory. We're going to reset it. Now here's something pretty neat. J and K are both high for several times. It toggles, toggles, it toggles, it toggles, it toggles. Just think about this. What if I always left J and K in toggle mode? It would constantly bounce back between 0 and 1, 0 and 1, 0 and 1. Last one, it looks like we're in a set command. So what happens? Look at our timing diagram here. We were a zero. We stayed a zero until that first positive edge happened. We set it. We stayed set. We memorized it. We reset it. We reset something that was already reset. We toggled. We switched. Toggled. 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 Finally, we set something that was already set. So hopefully you understood these JK flip-flop examples. Again, you can't buy this stuff. I mean, you got to go ahead and practice this. It's a very important concept to understand how these sequential devices behave given certain inputs. One quick thing here too, before we move on to the next lecture, is does Q instantaneously respond to those synchronous inputs? The answer is no. There is a bit of propagation delay. Just like we talked about in those edge detection devices. In an edge detection device, we're purposely delaying it, but realize that there might be a slight delay for some of these things to actually happen. There might be a delay here. So these are real world effects. These are not these idealized versions anymore of devices. That's actually the next topic of our lecture is flip-flop operating characteristics, where we take into account some of those real-world effects, and we're actually going to go into some of the other applications of sequential devices.